If you like the video, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified on every new upload.
Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to my channel. And for those of you who are new here, welcome to my channel. Now, every one of you who is listening to me right now must have heard about the love triangle. But you know what? We also have a triangle in our neck, and particularly speaking, the side of the neck. So today, we are going to study about the triangles of neck, how these triangles are formed, and what is the significance of studying this triangle. And by the way, please ignore the background noise you can hear, because this is the time when my entire family is kind of hyperactive, because it's dinner time, all the ladies are in the kitchen, except me obviously. So please forgive that. I'll try to edit the background noise, but since I'm not a professional editor, this can be difficult and I might not succeed. So with that said, let's jump right into the video. Okay, so I'm going to draw a human face. And I'll make sure this looks like a human and not something else, because my drawing, as you can see, is horrible. This is our human and we are looking at the side of the face. So this is the front of his neck and this is the back of the neck. Okay. Now, we have some structures here. This is the acromion. And this right here is the clavicle. And then here we have something which is called the sternum. Okay. Now, one muscle of importance here will be this muscle right here. I'll try to color it. This is the trapezius muscle. Okay. So we have a muscle at the back of our neck and that is the trapezius muscle. We also have one more neck and that is the sternocleidomastoid. So it is somewhat like this. So now when we have made these muscles, we can kind of appreciate two triangles. We have one triangle right here and we have one triangle right here. So the triangle that is anteriorly, that is called the anterior triangle. Anterior triangle of neck, and the triangle which is towards the back, or say posteriorly, that is the posterior triangle of the neck. Posterior triangle of the neck. So we saw that this muscle right here, which is the sternocleidomastoid, it divides the neck into two triangles, the anterior triangle and the posterior triangle. Okay, so first of all, we'll study about the anterior triangle. So in the anterior part of the neck, we have this hyoid bone, let's suppose. And we have a muscle that is called the digastric muscle. So let's suppose we have this muscle, digastric muscle. And the digastric muscle has two bellies. Okay, we call them bellies. The one that is towards the front, that is the anterior belly, and the one that is towards the back, that is the posterior belly. Okay. We also have one more muscle in the anterior triangle of neck, and that is the omohyoid muscle. And to be precise, we have the superior belly of omohyoid, because the inferior belly is in the posterior triangle. But now we are talking about the anterior triangle. So let's just remove this. Okay, so we have this muscle. This is the superior belly of omohyoid. Now, our triangle is divided into certain small number of triangles, isn't it? So let us see what triangles we are talking about. So this triangle right here, this is the digastric triangle. Digastric triangle. Then a triangle which is formed here, because when you see from the front, you can appreciate it. That is the submental triangle. Then we have triangle right here. This is the muscular triangle. Muscular triangle. Then this triangle is called the carotid triangle. carotid triangle. Okay. So we saw that from one anterior triangle, we got four smaller triangles, and that was formed by these small muscles. Okay, coming to the posterior triangle of neck, we saw that we have the inferior belly of omohyoid here. This is our inferior belly of omohyoid. So this belly, it divides the posterior triangle into two smaller triangles, and these are, this is the occipital triangle, and this right here, this is the supraclavicular triangle, and this is also called as subclavian triangle. So this wasn't short about the divisions of the neck into anterior triangle and the posterior triangle. In the next video, we'll study about the boundaries of these triangle and the contents of this triangle. So I hope you found this video helpful. If yes, please let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.